White Treagles?
What's that then?
So it's here.
It's now. It's game day.
Yeah! Yeah! Oh, fucking in the ball! Yeah! Oh my God! What a goal! Yeah! Yeah! Barnet!
We are an absolute embarrassment and a circus. Dooku goes down injured. Jack Barnes going to warm up. He's coming on. Jack Barnes ready just to come on, and then they're told he can play on. What's going on here? Don't know our arse from our elbow. Solihull Moors have stuck about five players up front there. We're sitting too deep. We're not holding onto the ball. We're just lumping it up, and he keeps coming back all the time.
Yes! No! No! That seals it!
All right, Treagles. What's happening?
I won't be making many videos this month. It's here. It's now. It's game day.
We're home for this one. We're off to the Hive. It's Barnet v Solihull Moors. So why Solihull are now bankrolled by new owners, we couldn't even pick a squad of 16 for our last game. Due to having 13 players out injured, with no real timescale of when they're coming back, it's pretty much like putting your car into the mechanic.
Yeah, be ready like next Tuesday. Don't know what year though.
And we've blown our entire budget for the season on Sunday League players.
But anyway, apart from that, that's enough of chatting bollocks. Let's get into the football news.
So Solihull finished 18th last season, where they played 46, they won 14, they drew 12, and they lost 20. They scored 49, conceded 60, giving them a goal difference of minus 11, and they ended on 54 points. Solihull currently sit 5th, and their last 5 games have been 4 wins and 1 loss, winning their last 4 on the bounce as well. Tim Flowers is in charge of the Moors. No, not that kind. And the ex-premiership winner has been in charge since the 20th of June 2018, where his record stands at 14 games in charge, winning 9, drawing once, and losing 4, giving him a win percentage of 64.29%. How's that, Aldous? Is that all right for you? Number 19, Danny Wright, who leads the way with most goals of 6 and 1 assist in 14 games. Number 8, Darren Carter, who leads the way with most assists with 3 and 1 goal in 13 games. Last meet between us two? Yep, you guessed it. Never played them before in our history. So, let's get to the grand. Let's get some team news in. Let's get 3 points. And then let's get the fuck out of town. Fuck you, Solihull Moors. You bunch of Jasper Carrot.
All right, how are you?
Dumb wankers. Come on, Barnet! Barnet starting 11 is in, and we've gone back to the 3-5-2 formation. Mark Cousins in between the sticks. Shad Alexander as your right fullback. David Totonda as your left fullback. Your back three of Craig Robson, Dan Sweeney, and Zach Jules. Your flat three midfield of Wesley Fongook, Charlie Adams, and Jack Taylor. And up front, Josh Walker, and a new guy making his debut on loan from Cheltenham, Manny Duku. And this is how Solihull Moors line up. I'm telling you, they're starting to listen to me with their graphics now. They're all pulling their finger out.
15 in, still 0-0 here. Not a great deal to report about. We've had one opportunity. We broke from a throw-in from Solihull Moors down on our edge. Nice little play. Josh Walker was fed through, but keeper done well to get rid of it. 20 in, still 0-0. A fantastic shot and effort by number 9, Youssef, from out of nowhere. For a corner, but nothing came of that. Half hour in, it's still 0-0. We are an absolute embarrassment and a circus. Duku goes down injured. As I'm saying that, Totonda puts in a ball and Duku just knocks it over the bar. But anyway, Duku goes down injured. Jack Barnes going to warm up, he's coming on. Jack Barnes ready just to come on, and then they're told he can play on. What's going on here? Don't know our arse from our elbow. About 10 to the half, still 0-0. There's not been much to report at all from either side. Half time here at the Hive, it's Barnet 0, it's Solihull Moors 0. Not a lot to report. To be honest with you, one chance from either side. Very slow with our play and decision making as well. Probably controlled it better possession wise. Maybe because of the weather, our players are taking a bit cautious because of all the injuries we've had. We don't need to walk the pitch. as it's pissing down, but I wouldn't put it past us to do that. The only thing to really talk about was the Manny went down injured, was going to bring on Barham, then all of a sudden he's carried on playing. John still turning and had to go to the medical team. Told you, we're a circus from start to finish. I just hope the second half brings more excitement than the first half did. Come on, Barnet.
Go on! It's it! Yes! Get in there!
Fucking
60 minutes in, it's Barnet 1, it's Solihull Moors 0. Wesley Fongook has put us 1-0 up. Ball fed through to Josh Walker into the box. His shirt was pulled, but he's knocked it through to Wesley Fongook. He's put us 1-0 up. Much better start from us in the second half. We have upped it now. We're playing some better football. There it goes, yes, yes!
Oh, he's in here.
Go on, the star! Yes! Oh, no! 65 minutes in, we're still leading 1-0. Best play all game. Throwing from us, lovely little 1-2 between Jack Taylor. Shea puts the ball in, a defender knocks it out, lands to Manny, he has a crack straight at the keeper. Still 1-0 to us. Grown so much in confidence now that we've got this goal. But the two centre-halves, Solihull Moors number 5 and 6, are pretty much cleaning everything up for them. 15 left to go, we're still leading 1-0. Since we've scored, it's been all of us. We've completely controlled the game. I know it's Barnet. We always need that second goal to kill teams off. Josh Walker's just coming off now for Jackie Barham. Come on, mate, do your sponsor proud. And there we are, riding the luck again. About 5 minutes to go, we're still leading 1-0. Number 4 chips in a ball to the back post. Win marking no one. There's two at the back post, 3, but neither one of them got to it. How easy was that though? Nice simple tap in. Positioning. We're into the 90 minute. If they just added on 9. All down to this. Fourth official changing with the lino. It's probably about 4 minutes remaining. We're still leading 1-0. Solihull Moors have stuck about 5 players up front there. We're sitting too deep. We're not holding onto the ball. We're just lumping it up and it keeps coming back all the time. We need to hold on to this ball. Can't just keep kicking it away.
Yes! No! No! Yes!
That seals it! Just back in the 99th minute. Barnet 2, Solihull Moors 0. Fongook with his second goal. Trying to hold it into the corner. Referee gives a free kick to Solihull Moors for some unknown reason. They're not paying attention. They play the back pass. Jack Barham's squared it. Fongook, bang, has some of that.
So the game finished Barnet 2, Solihull Moors 0. And to be honest with you, I didn't see that coming. I honestly thought it was going to be another frustrating game by us where we just struggled to break down a team. First half, there was nothing for either side. I think both teams had one shot on target and that was about it in the first half to talk about. Second half started a bit brighter. We managed to get a goal and then from there we just kicked on and grew in confidence. And then as the game went on, we managed to get a second goal. And this is why in this league that anyone could beat anyone. Going into this game, Solihull were 5th. Just won their last 4 on a bounce and didn't concede a single goal. It didn't really trouble us a lot. And if that's the standard we're coming up against, then as soon as we get some players back fit, we should be able to kick on from here. The only real threat that Solihull had was right up front. He was pretty much all elbows and arms and just a lot of effort and huffing and puffing, but nothing came towards him. We put ourselves under a bit of pressure with the last minutes where we did sit back deep and always invite that pressure like we always do. But the boys did well. They'd done their job. They worked hard. I really wish we could somehow key holder Zach Jules until the end of the season. The guy's head and shoulders too good for this league. We wouldn't be able to afford him, but since he's come in we have looked a lot better. I thought Manny did really well as well, but my man Jack Barham off the bench to set up Fongook for his second goal. Get hold of that. Brilliant to see that Fongook is now growing into a great player. When was the last time we had someone from midfield popping up and scoring a load of goals? The last person I could think of doing that was Dean Sinclair. I'm not going to sit here and praise every single one of you individually. You've done your job and that's all that matters, and we got the win. I thought the two centre-halves of Solihull Moors did clean up a lot. But now, our next game, we'll wait to see who we get drawn in the FA Cup tomorrow. We would be playing Sutton next week, but as they're in that Scottish Cup, that game's been postponed. So I can't tell you who we're playing next. I'd love it to be Billericay. So make sure you do the usual crap, like, subscribe, comment, share, and all that bollocks. So until next time, because I don't know who we're playing yet, I'll see you later.